mean giant of the rhyme contrivers. Supreme violence of the time prescribers. I'm with the side, you evil iris. A pile driver, provider for dyers. The sleep deprived, the nick of time. Where she killed the nine in a crime. I could have moved up a Brutus MacGyver. A slap a yapper from the empty to the...
Coming up next, the matchup for the UFC lightweight division title. Lightweight contender making his way to the octagon and looking to leave as the new undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world. He has bided his time, waiting for this title shot. He's got the winning streak. He has the quality of opposition. Now he's fighting the number one guy in the world. He believes he's the best. Now his opportunity to prove it, just a few minutes away. The reigning, defending, undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world. Of course, the target is on his back. All eyes are on this man tonight as he tries to make good on yet another title defense. He has owned this division for some time. The question is, as the challenges get stiffer, can he remain the hunted? Several championship fights to his credit, a lot of 25-minute wars. As he gets older, the challenges get stiffer. We'll see how he handles this one tonight. Our tale of the tape for this, our main event of the evening. More than 5 years apart, with similar height and the same reach. The veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. It's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC lightweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 35 wins, 15 losses, and one draw.
He stands 5'10" tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Fontana, California, presenting the challenger, Bobby King Green. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 28 wins, 3 losses.
He stands 5'9" tall, weighing in at 149 pounds. Fighting out of Sao Paulo, Brazil, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world, Mahazo.
All right, this is for the championship. You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Just make it official.
Ready.
So here he is after a win by submission in his previous championship fight. We'll see what he can produce for an encore. It was an outstanding performance to win the title a few short months ago. Now we'll see what he can do to follow it up. Fans are excited. Oh, and Imanari rolled right into a heel hook attempt, or so it looks. Man, this is flashy, certainly effective here tonight. Let's see if he can close the show from here.
Thank you.
Why is he not recognizing this right now? He's got to recognize this is dangerous. This is a dangerous position.
It's in there deep. There you go.
Brilliant submission defense there. Oh, nice job to get back up again. You don't want to hang out on the ground with this guy. Oh, and he lands a punch there. Good connection.
Oh! Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Oh, man.
Oh, do you see what you look at this? The Imanari roll out of nowhere. And now right into a heel hook transition. His opponent has been rendered defensive here. Let's see if he can survive. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. Oh, man, it ain't Dikembe Mutombo, but he is blocking all these shots coming
this
way.
Man, get that out of here. He sees it coming. You're going to have to mix. The record is on repeat. Wash and rinse over and over again. It's takedown after takedown.
Just over 3 minutes to go in our first round.
Now look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
All right, side control now. We'll see if he can advance position. All the ground and pound strikes continue to rain down. The opponent better move out of harm's way or the referee's gonna stop us.
He better start to move. And when his opponent starts to posture, he needs to put his feet on the hip, push him away to try to escape this very, very dangerous position.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Crazy accuracy and efficiency with these ground and pound strikes here. And if you're the opponent, you got to intelligently defend or the referee's going
to
stop
you. You got to defend, but you can see him now start to gain posture, and the intensity at which he's throwing these ground strikes is starting to improve. It's starting to elevate because he knows that he can get the finish.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
2 minutes to go. All right, good movement by him here on the ground. He really is a master of these transitions.
He is a master of movement on the ground. You never know where he's going to be.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
All right, a good ground and pound by him here. Certainly staying busy, and not just busy, but effective.
You can just throw punches to keep the referee off you. This guy is throwing punches to be effective, to throw damaging strikes. He's doing a fantastic job.
All right, dominant position here. He's got the full mount. A lot of different ways he can go here. Maybe try to find an arm bar or just get the ground and pound.
He can attack submissions, but those submissions will present themselves once he is landing that brutal ground and pound he is known for. Because then his opponent will start to get a little bit desperate to get out from under him, which will then in turn leave arms dangling, or he'll turn to his knees and get choked out.
Under a minute to go in the round. Seconds remain in the round. Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. All right, great position for him here. He's got the full mount. See if he can get that ground and pound going.
Oh, he's got to get it going, but he can't rush. A lot of times, guys get in the full mount, and they rush. They get nervous. They're like, oh, my goodness, I'm winning. Reality is, you're winning, but it can change in a matter of seconds because then they can be gone. He's got to drop his hips, be really heavy at the opponent's face, and then just start to work. Make the opponent give his back so that he can try to get his chokes off or find great ground and pound, but very patient ground and pound from such a dominant position.
Horn sounds for the end of round one.
Ready to go, okay? This round, I want him out of there.
All right, so his legend.